what do I do when I'm pulling the driveway with my dog in the car and she sees the neighbor coming out of her apartment next to the driveway? She growls. I tell her no. She lowers head, but does it again.
Shock, cower, make it suck. See, this is the thing. It's like a lot of people are like, whoa, he just uses the shock collar for everything. It's like, no. But for a lot of the questions that people are asking me, it's the perfect tool. It's like the best tool for this. My dog's at the front window and it barks its head off. What do I do? Shock collar correction. My dog's at the back fence barking its head off. What do I do? Shock collar correction. My dog's chasing the cat. What do I do? Shock collar correction. My dog's in the car and it growls or barks at the neighbor. What do I do? Shock collar correction. It's the perfect tool. It's the perfect tool. How do I teach a good sit? Leash and food. A good down. Leash and food. A good place. Leash and food. Recall. Leash and food. Roll over. Food and a clicker. Paw. Food and a clicker. Walk backwards. Food and a clicker. Spin in circles. Figure eights. Food and a clicker. Like, there's great tools for so many applications. For so many applications. Going live. Now we're live. Guys, how are you? Jeff Gellman of Solid Canine Training. This is Joel. It is Wednesday night. What Would Jeff Do show. It's a 90-minute show tonight. We're going to get right through this, get right into it, but a little bit of an intro first. First of everybody that's listening on Spotify, SoundCloud, iHeartRadio, Apple Podcast, any of the Google Sound platforms. Thank you so much. If you're watching the replay, thank you so much for watching the replay as well. As far as the live show, you can ask your comments. So comments are asked on the live show, during the live show. There's something down at the bottom called the top chat. It has a dollar sign. And the reason why that is because the people, some people just want to throw us cash thanking us for the 15 years of free content that's dramatically helped them change their dog's lives. Or they want their question to go to the top of the queue and we answer it. But you do not have to pay to play. We try to get through every single question here. What we do here up in Providence, Rhode Island at our training centers, we rehab dogs. We work with human aggression, dog aggression, leash reactivity, separation anxiety, really challenging dogs. But we have a new puppy program too. So we work with 8-week-old puppies. We actually have a whole puppy room. So that's fantastic. We'll be showcasing more of that. We just had our first group puppy class. We do pack walks. As far as my seminars, I do 25 seminars on the road. Joelle travels with me on those. Very important part of the seminar series, the success of the seminar series. I'm in year 5. We're doing 25 of those a year. Go to Jeff Gellman Seminars, Jeff Gellman Seminars to see that schedule. I'll be in Buffalo this weekend. If anybody wants to go to that seminar, definitely want to jump on that one. And then I'm going to be in Vancouver, British Columbia. Vancouver, the proposed ban on tools and the word no. Did you guys know that? They were proposing you couldn't use the word no in your training. Like, no shock collars and you can't use the word no. Let's just bundle it all together and just like see if we can pass it. But enough people were outraged about that because whether you like the shock collars or not, they have an important part to a training program. And then those are problem-solving seminars. You pretty much learn how to stop unwanted behaviors. This podcast is a problem-solving podcast. I think people really need to understand what this show is about. It is a problem-solving contest. I talk about things nobody in the industry is willing to publicly talk about. They won't talk about punishment. They won't talk about high-level corrections. They won't talk about stopping unwanted behaviors. They make dog training appear to be all fun. Yeah, until it's not. And when a dog is trying to bite you, it's not fun. When a dog is being leash reactive, it's not fun. When a dog is destroying a crate, eating through a wall, it's not fun. When you can't take your dog anywhere, it's not fun. And I'm looking for you to have a resemblance of a decent life and stop being prisoners of your own homes and finally enjoying your dog for the first fucking time. I swear. All right. So you all ask the questions? Here we go. We just saw $1.99 chop chat. It doesn't come up, but it came up early
enough.
There was
$5 from Hayden.
Hey, Hayden. Thank you so much, Hayden.
So I'll start with his, even though it didn't, like, come up.
Yep.
6 month golden retriever pup, very submissive but also excited to meet people and dogs, sometimes barks with hackles up to dogs. Once close enough she pulls hard to get closer despite being on the prong. Wondering if correcting the initial arousal is appropriate in this case or keep working on just existing nearby.
So do both. Number one is correct the initial arousal. Number two, do not allow your dog to meet other dogs on leash. Don't do it. The dog is working. It should be focused on you, not competition focused. Focused on you. It should be ignoring all people and all dogs. Start right there. Next.
Derek Price donated $1.99.
Oh, thank you, Derek. That was nice of you.
Annie, hey, you too. I've been stalking you for a while. Good content. Amazing when applied. Thanks for everything. Ooh, a stalker comes out.
That's right. We like our stalkers. Thank you.
Sebastian, hey guys, haven't been able to catch a live show in a bit. How would you correct a male dog for marking outdoors, or would you at all? I know dogs don't mentally mature until about 18 months.
The male dog, what's the behavior? First of all, I'm not a big fan of marking, so I guess I don't give a shit. I would use a shock collar for that. I'm not a big fan of marking. Next.
Travis, walking my dog at a flea market with his prong on, past a little dog lunging and growling at us. Lady said that collar is cruel. I replied, F you, my dog is not out of control, and walked away. Love y'all.
Good. Absolutely. That's right.
F you.
As her dog is lunging at you. What a rude, rude, rude person. You know? That's so rude to do. Next.
Tammy Cobb. Dog in a downstay and will move around the general area. Never actually gets up, but will end up a few feet from the original place of down.
No.
Wondering when to correct.
When do you think?
Army crawling.
When do you think you're going to correct? When the dog ends up at the 7-Eleven and is in front of the Slurpee machine.
You know who that is? That's who? Rizzo's owner. Rizzo army crawling?
Is Rizzo army crawling? Rizzo didn't army
and
crawl with us.
She's got housemates. It could be one of the other dogs.
None of those dogs should be army crawling. You've known us too long. Next.
Luke, hey brother and sister. Hey Luke.
Hey, how are you?
Jill, what do we search on iHeartRadio to find your podcast?
What would Jeff do? Well, you're on it now, but what would Jeff do? Just do that. Jeff Gellman, what would Jeff do? You'll find it.
Melissa, good evening, Jeff and Joelle.
Hey, how are you?
Hey, Melissa.
Don't read your questions. Next.
Justin, when to stop using prong collar? Is using every day too much for a dog that still needs obedience training?
No. Guys, a prong collar is not your last choice. A prong collar is not a crutch. A prong collar, if you're going to have a leash attached to something on the dog, why not be the collar that empowers you the most? Why not? I'm amazed that people are trying to work off of that tool. No. Next.
Brooklyn, I have an exceptionally hyper puppy, and everything I try only gets her more riled up or trying to get me to play with her. She's near inexhaustible and driving me nuts. What do I do?
If she spent 30 minutes with me, she'd be lying down calm. You need to learn the master of getting rid of arousal. So, I'm a big fan of exercise. I'm a big fan of training. I'm a big fan of working the dog. I'm a big fan of some free time, but I'm even a bigger fan of teach the dog to do nothing. So, a bonker, which is a cotton towel wrapped up, watch my video, is a great tool to get rid of arousal. Teach place. Next.
Rosie, every time I put the shock collar on my dog, she just hides in her crate after it's on.
Okay, you might even, first of all, close the crate door. Second of all, this dog should be on a leash. Third of all, you probably introduced it to your dog incorrectly. It should be used for on small prompting nicks with tons of food. They barely even notice it. Next.
Sebastian, how would you go about decreasing nervousness in dogs while out in public and increase calmness, confidence?
It's definitely a two-way. It sort of works in parallel with each other. Number one, obedience train. Obedience train your dog and hold your dog up to a high standard and just do stuff with your dog. Keep your dog in command and do things with your dog. Go places. Stay in a proper heel. Lie down right here. Don't worry about the world. I got it covered. Next.
K Kaylee J. Oh, no, I skipped one. Sorry. Sebastian, how would you go about... Oh, no, I read that. Sorry, guys. Kaylee J. Good evening, Jeff and Joelle. Finally seeming to break through some of the whining. Woohoo! Thank you both so much for doing these shows and providing support for all of us.
About fucking time.
Next. Did she ever Skype with you?
No.
Hayden.
I probably wouldn't Skype with her.
Says, hello from Calgary, Canada.
Hey, Hayden. How are you?
N Leap, would you come to Singapore? Love all your videos.
Yes, I will come to Singapore. In fact, I have a place where I can actually do the seminar there.
Do you?
It bends. Yep.
Cool.
Yep, I got a place there. But if you have a location, I can do it. Jeff at Solid Canine Training. Jeff at Solid Canine Training. Email me. Let's plan a Singapore seminar. I can do Singapore and then Brisbane. Next. Nice. I found a location in Brisbane. Next.
You didn't tell me that. So this is...
I found a location in Brisbane this morning.
Part two of Rosie's thing. She says, the dog won't come out at all. Even if I close the crate, she just lays next to it all day. Any tips?
Yes. Actively train your dog. Where's the leash and where's the human doing something? Got it? Stop letting this dog make such decisions. Next.
Michelle, good evening, Jeff and Joelle.
Hello.
Ryan, hi Jeff and Joelle. Hope you're both having a great day. Thanks for your time.
Fantastic day.
Duncan, how do I determine the right setting for the shock collar? And does this need to be adjusted from standard training compared to a Punisher? For example, does the Punisher have to be much higher?
Yes. So what I want you to do is, before you start using a shock collar, I want you to fully understand what all the buttons do, fully understand what it does, what levels mean anything. But if somebody tells you a number the dog should be on for basic obedience, they're lying to you, because you would never know, because you don't know what the lowest perception level, the working level, the dog feels. It does come with an owner's manual. Read it front to back and then read it again. We've got tons of free videos. A lot of my colleagues have free videos. Watch all those videos as well. You can always find somebody to work with, but understand it tremendously. Yes.
Raphael, I have a 2-year-old obsessively licking the 4-year-old. I can make it suck to lick the other dog. However, my concern is that it may harm the relationship that the dogs have.
Okay. What's that relationship they have? What is the relationship? What's your interpretation of the relationship? So, who doesn't like the licking? You or the other dog? Because if it's the other dog's probably going, will you fucking do something with this dog owner? Because I'm going to bite its head off. If neither dog minds it, leave it alone. Next.
Luke says, laugh my ass off.
Okay, Luke. There you go.
Derek, 11 and a half week staffy bull, a lot of nipping, biting, pressing down quickly on tongue. Has helped a bit. Any other suggestions or just consistency? I don't want it to become a bigger problem.
No, either do I. Bonk the dog. No. So, this is the bonker. No. Deploy it. Hard. Next.
Sebastian, dog is 9 months old and usually marks on fresh pee spots. Used to rush my female dogs while they peed and I cut that out. It's just annoying to have him peeing everywhere. A pee scent is...
So, do the same thing you did with the rushing of the females.
Cody, riding out thunderstorm on patio with storm anxiety dog, keep reinforcing down but doesn't stick. She was fine in someone else's house, fine in the car, freaked out as soon as we got to my apartment.
Yeah, it's situational. Leash on the dog, use leash pressure. Next.
Cody, already read that. Juliana, my dog is prong collar smart. Without it on, he thinks his commands are optional. With it on, he's perfect and will lay down for hours. Is it silly to have a prong on when it's just relaxing at home on place?
No, not at all. You're training. Your training. Next.
Emily, please tell me how I can teach my 9-month dog that he's a boy and to lift his leg and tilt his hips when he pees. He's pissing on his front leg. Send help. It's gross.
Okay. So, believe it or not, I studied the hip tilt for 3 straight years. I went to classes for 40 hours a week. I got to the master's level of hip tilting, so I'm more than qualified to answer the question. And after all that time, my answer is, I still have no fucking idea what you're talking about. This is the thing. I have no idea. I got no idea what to do. I got no idea what to do. That's not what I do. Next.
Wes does it too.
Yeah.
I don't know.
So does Tex. Yep. But Wes is the master of pissing on his fucking... He's the master of pissing on his front feet and then getting into my truck.
Yeah.
He's so good at it. He's so good at it. Next.
Amy, buying my ticket to Elkhart soon, just getting together the money. Woo.
Awesome. See you in Elkhart.
Ari, feeling kind of overwhelmed with balancing dog training, work, household maintenance, personal fitness, mental health, etc. Any words of wisdom?
Yeah, number one, work on yourself first. So Ari, mental health and fitness are at the top. Got it? Mental health and fitness are at the top. What was else was in there?
A lot. Household maintenance, personal fitness, mental health, dog training, work.
Okay. You could make dog training your work. So, but if dog training doesn't pay, work is next. So, mental health, fitness, work, dog training, household management would be last. But depends. If you've got three kids, that goes up. Next. You just need some time management skills. In order to have better time management skills, you need to make sure you've got good boundary setting skills. Mm-hmm. You need to learn how to say no. So that's what a lot of that is. You can always do a Skype with me. I'll help you out. I'll set you straight. Next.
I struggle with that.
Mm-hmm.
Sounds like someone I know.
Sounds like someone I know.
Derek, 10-4, you rock, bro.
Thank you, good buddy.
Holding on, dog training. Good friend. Happy Wednesday, Jeff and Joelle. Finally back to watch. Thank goodness. Thanks for everything.
Oh, how is Canada,
eh? Yeah, how is Canada? Are you done smoking? Because wasn't that the deal? Once you finished that Canada trip, she was done?
She should have been done a long time ago. Should be smoking something else.
Mm-hmm. Ryan says, my dogs will pee on the feet sometimes too, huh? Yeah. Charles just took a piss and mastered the hip tilt. Turf.
You know, Ryan. Ask Ryan. Ryan, start your own show.
Teach everybody.
That's right. Where's Keto Dave? Keto Dave, fuck that keto stuff.
The hip tilt.
Do the hip tilt show. hip tilt show. Your audience will be bigger. Next.
Turv. Hey, Jeff and Joelle, happy hump day. How do I get my dog to get over the fear of bikes? I try to take my dog on bike rides, but he always shuts down, freezes up, or hurries past the bike I have.
So what you're going to do is prong collar on the dog, leash on the dog, get your bike, walk. Walk your dog next to the bike. First of all, make sure your dog knows how to heel. Walk your dog next to the bike, do that for a while, then get on the bike, go really slow, put the dog in heel. Next.
Goblin says hello.
Hey, do you have a super chat from a...
Catherine.
Yeah. Hey, thanks, Goblin.
That's Canadian, 549.
Hey.
But I don't see a question.
Okay, thanks, Catherine, for the 549 Canadian, eh?
It didn't come to the top either. It's so weird. Debbie Kebby says thank you for all you do.
Oh, thank you so much for consuming. Guys, thank you all for what you do. All right? I'm just the guy with the big mouth. And everyone's like, no shit, Jeff. I'm just the guy with a big mouth. Speaking of the big mouth, if you like this big mouth, give me a thumbs up. If you don't like this big mouth, give me a thumbs down. But if you don't like this big mouth, but you like Joelle, thumbs up. So we should get technically no thumbs down.
Stop.
You know, but you guys are the ones that are doing all the hard work. All of you. All of you. Well, probably Joelle, too, because this is the end of her day. These are her nights off. So, but me, I don't give a shit. I'm here all the time. But kudos to all of you. Next.
I don't even know what you're talking about right now. did I read Cody's? No.
I don't know.
Dog recovering from metal allergy, getting nickel-free points for e-collar.
Yep.
Will prong collar have same effect if I put a bandana underneath?
Yes and no, but they make some Kurrigan prong collars. They make nickel-free prong collars as well. Next.
Jacqueline, today I corrected my dog for breaking a downstay while he was waiting to be recalled back to me. He tried to flee, so should I correct again and then guide him back to downstay with a leash?
Yes, keep a leash on the dog, put the dog on a tie back, and work him through the tie back because he can't flee very far. Then you'll work him through troubleshooting how to get back on into a down. Next.
66 El Camino, whiny 9-month-old pup. Ugh.
Whining?
Whining.
Yeah, remote collar, low level, stop the whining. Next.
Ari, sorry, Joelle, you haven't met my Whippet. Not only does he piss on his legs, but his chest, too. He's not only known as nose flute, but also piss legs in my house.
Piss legs, like what?
Piss legs.
Piss legs? Piss chest. Guys got a
fucking. She was sending me DMs the other day of people playing the recorder on YouTube.
The recorder?
I was crying, remember?
Oh, because you mentioned the recorder? Right. Ari, you sound like a really nice person.
Oh, so funny. I was dying.
Next.
Aldo, morning from Indonesia, guys. Would you give me 2-month puppy protocol, Jeff? Which age would you start walking them?
So 2-month protocol, well, at 2 months we don't do much with these dogs except for sit, down, place, tons of recall, no jumping, no biting, go in your crate, and shut up. Walking, you can walk the dog around the backyard, but I'm in no rush, and then tons of confidence building stuff. But I'm not in a big rush to actually walk the dog. Next.
Sebastian, will correcting my dog for marking make him not want to pee in the yard in general?
See, that's the thing. That's the catch 22 you got to be careful of. That's why I tend not to give advice on pissing. Speaking of pissing.
The best dog helper ever. Trainer. Hey. Distraction.
So Angelo comes to work every day now.
The best.
Except for Fridays.
And your sister's coming to work every day. Right? I heard you did some out training today with a German Shepherd. Okay. It's on Instagram.
He didn't even know I was recording him.
If anybody wants to see Angelo do some cool stuff on Instagram, you can do that.
He's doing what?
If you want to see him work a Malinois German Shepherd through Chuck It, check out IG Stories. Right? We had fun today? Nice. Who are you representing? Anybody out there from Volcom? Who are you promoting? Who's your sponsor? Who's your YouTube
skateboarding company?
Who's your YouTube sponsor?
I don't know.
Volcom. Okay. Get to bed. Did you brush your teeth?
Oh yeah. Oh yeah, Papa. That thing's like a mirror.
I know. Okay.
Bye.
Bye. Love you.
That thing's like a mirror. Is he just realizing that?
It's like he's been
comes in here every night.
He's been looking at screens his whole life.
You didn't answer. So the dog pissing in the yard, does it make it not want to piss? Marking?
I think if you correct the dog in the house, that could really work against you sometimes. That's why you just pull the dog outside. I don't have enough experience with that to give an answer. Next.
Got it. Kristen, thank you so much for all your free content. I'll be going to your seminar in Providence. Excited to meet you.
Awesome. That'll be a good one. Yeah, that one sells out every year.
We always get the craziest dogs, too.
I know.
I love it.
They all try to bite me.
Yep.
That one sells out. Vegas is looking good.
Nice.
Vegas is slow and steady. San Francisco, round two. Damn.
I can't wait.
That one's going to fucking sell out.
I really like San Francisco.
Jesus Christ, that one's going to sell out and sell out quick. I got to book. You know, I got to book the Airbnb.
Are you doing dinner with Jeff for Vegas?
Yeah.
Are people going?
Those are half sold out.
Nice.
Yeah. You too. You're going to be there.
I thought I was going to like just hang out, go gamble.
You could if you want to.
Me and Sarah have plans.
So go gamble because dinner's going to cost me money. So
win big.
You guys can go sit Thursday night.
It's actually during the day. We're going to lay out.
Oh, so Thursday we get there.
So it'll probably be Friday.
No, we get there Thursday at like 10 in the morning.
Oh, okay.
Yeah, it's Vegas. You leave here at 6, you get there at 10.
Cool.
Yeah. Next.
Anya, I adopted a Chihuahua mix, 1.5 years old in April. He's a Velcro dog, does well with potty training, but poops and occasionally pees when I'm not home or busy in the house. Help.
So you're not crating him. I've got a feeling you're not crating him. Why are you not crating your dog? And it also sounds like if he's a Velcro dog, he's going to have separation anxiety. So let's get that dog in a crate. Next.
Cassandra, I've been listening to a lot of replays lately, and I noticed Jeff often says something else after saying next. Does the word next not have meaning anymore?
What else do I say after next?
You'll start talking again. Like, you'll say next because
My next has gotten my next has my.
He'll just say it.
Yeah.
They're like mid conversation.
Yes.
Next.
I've got next Tourette. Definitely. Next.
66 El Camino says, "Love you, big mouth."
He's talking to you, right?
No. Next. Debbie Kebby gave a thumbs up.
Thanks, Debbie.
Raphael, any chance of a seminar near San Diego in 2020?
Yeah, I'd like to do something in San Diego, but come out to Vegas, Raphael.
Vegas.
Go to the Vegas seminar. It's so close. You know you go to Vegas. You know you've been there. You know you make the drive. You and your buddies, how many times? You probably don't remember, but you've been there, all right? So jeffgellmanseminars.com. Get your ass to Vegas. It's going to be a fun one. Mm-hmm. It's actually at the Flamingo Hotel and Casino. We finally hit the big time, baby. That's incredible.
They have good breakfast there?
They got good everything there.
You know how I feel about breakfast.
Yes, but we're gonna eating breakfast in the room.
True.
We're gonna go to the gym and eat breakfast in the room next.
Goblin gave us a thumbs up.
Hey, thanks, Goblin.
Holding on dog training. Canada was amazing. Actually, it was nice to see a city with well-behaved dogs since no one let anyone meet their dog. It was nice.
Yeah, it's nice.
Teresa, hey Joelle, hey Jeff, hope all is well. You guys do seminars in Oklahoma by any chance? Also, got two of our dogs swimming this past week. Thank you, as always.
Where's Oklahoma? Is that in the United States? We do one in Austin, Texas. Head south. Do you know Oklahoma is one of the only stickers that I don't have on my old RV that I've driven through?
Really?
Yeah.
I feel like I've looked at that, though, and a lot of them didn't have stickers.
Well,
You just didn't document them.
The Pacific Northwest I haven't gotten to in the RV, but I've been to Texas so many times. In fact, one day I was like, you know what? I got to head back out to Ohio. Why don't I just shoot up to Oklahoma and go over, just so I can say the RV's been in Oklahoma.
What's the states that have four corners and you can be in all four at the same time? Like Utah and Nevada.
The Dakotas.
But there's four states, though.
New Mexico,
Arizona. Four corners. Where is it, guys?
New Mexico, Arizona, Texas, and Nevada?
Maybe. I don't think Texas.
Next.
Ray S. One for Jeff and one for Joelle. Thumbs up.
Thanks,
Ray. Feisty Pet Training and Boarding. Thanks for your help today, Jeff. I raised my prices right after our Skype. Look at that. She had a really long wait list.
I know. We had a good Skype.
Nice.
Yeah, she's really nice.
I bet she is.
She's really, really nice. Yeah, great. I'm proud of you. I am so proud of you. Next.
Goblin, seen video helping dad doing morning routine feeding. Oh, Angelo.
Oh, he was in a diaper, right? He was in a diaper.
That was a cute video.
And he was running through. Did he run down the front steps? Have you seen the video of him when he ran around? He was running around from the pool area, putting Mac back in his kennel.
No.
Yeah, that's a funny video too. Angela's first word was out. Yep.
Makes sense. Ashley, dealing with leash reactivity, I'm hitting the e-collar when he starts loading, but it actually pushes him into losing it. This is even the case at high levels. Don't know if it's still timing or still underwhelming.
It's most likely timing, but I would, believe it or not, set it up with the bonker. Set it up with a bonker and bonk. Next.
Feisty Pet Training and Boarding. My husband also says thank you. LOL. He has been trying to convince me to raise my prices for a while.
Tell hubby, we talked about a lot of things. Did you talk to him about the prosperity consciousness stuff? Did you? Ask him about that. Ask him about how familiar all of you are with prosperity consciousness. And then also, jump on a Randy Gage podcast, looking through some of his old content. All right? Just check it out. All right? Next.
It's the one time a husband's ever happy to hear what Jeff has to say.
That's not true.
Just kidding.
When I told Ashley to give up smoking and do more oil.
True.
Okay.
Jeff says
I have to stop smoking and give you more
oil.
That
should be a shirt. Jeff says.
I got freaking a text from him.
I'm sure you did.
All right. So.
I'm sure you did. Raphael, my Charlie pees on his left front leg. We call him Pea Leg Cheesehead Monkey Lover, or Pea Leg for short. Debbie, still trying to say that three times fast. Debbie. Still trying to stop my 2-year-old Aussie from charging the fence when people walk by, barking like a maniac, but it's not all dogs, people. I do have a remote collar, trying to get him at first arousal.
Okay, what level are you at? Because you should be at the highest level, keep the dog on a long line, hold the button down for 3 seconds, and then if you have to, give some leash guidance backwards. But it should totally suck to do that. Next.
Anya. My adopted Chihuahua also licks me, my leather furniture. I try to distract him, walk away, not working. Any advice?
Okay, yeah. This is the one that has separation anxiety, and this is the one that follows you around, and this is the one that shits and pisses in the house. This is the one that's not in the crate. This is the one that you've probably never told no to and applied a punisher to. Apply a punisher. Nothing, Anya, nothing will stop ever until you learn how to apply a punisher. Punishment is not yelling, it's not screaming, you're not mad, you're not upset, you're not doing timeout. It's just the word no with a consequence after it that the dog does not like. Next.
Paper plane, Kathy. My dog knows when he wears the e-collar and is great. We'll be flying with him to Germany in a few weeks. No collar allowed in crate. He's freaking out in the crate without e-collar and has bad separation anxiety.
So don't put your dog on drugs, please. That's not good to do. So you should, can you have a bark collar in a crate in cargo? Well, they're illegal in Germany, number one. So could you have it in cargo, a bark collar, in a crate with a bandana on? Think about that option. Next.
Michael, do you always say no before you correct with e-collar? If not, would be the difference? Could you give some examples? Thank you both.
Historically, prior to a punisher, you should say no, or you can always use the tone function. That could be your marker. All you need is a marker. So that could be the marker for no, and then you apply the punisher. Are there times when I don't? Yes. When? Counter surfing, litter box, eating shit, digging holes, getting in the trash, getting in the litter box, jumping up on people.
Fence fighting. Usually we don't.
Historically fence fighting, but
now we can do tone. We can do that.
Sorry, guys. God, it's 3:30 in the morning. I can't sleep past 3:30. I can't. I try.
All I know is my coffee intake has been real. It's bad. I need to like...
Well, stop it.
It's bad. I can't make it through the day.
That's because you're addicted.
It's bad.
It's not good.
Like, just drink it to drink it these days.
Yeah, you do. You drink it out of habit. Mm-hmm. Well, I made it easy for you at work now. I got you an ice tray. I got you ice cube things.
I keep my almond milk in your fridge now. I know. So I don't even have to go to the back.
The almond milk is there. I got you we got to buy coffee pods tomorrow.
I go. Drink way too much coffee.
You know what we're going to do is
we'll go. I wonder what my blood pressure is. It should be good. I'm pretty healthy.
I'll take it right now. I'll take it after the show.
Okay.
We're going to stop at the three. What's the name of that store that we stop at?
Market 32.
Market 32. Tomorrow we'll stop there on the way up to Buffalo. Next.
Anya, I crate him at night and he sleeps with me on occasion. How long is too long to crate him?
Okay. Don't let him sleep with you anymore. How long is too long? Overnight is not too long. If you work during the day, that's not too long. You have to have a job and you have to sleep. Next.
JP says, crated? I don't know what that's about. Oh, right here. Crate train dog marks around the house. What am I doing wrong?
I wouldn't let him free roam for now. Don't let him free roam for now. Teach him place. Pretty much when he's in the house, he's in place. That's going to be the easiest way to do it right now. Next.
Kristen, how would you correct resource guarding if the owner doesn't want to use an e-collar? Teach out with a prong?
That would be a non-client for me. I wouldn't take that client. So, because I don't let clients dictate training protocols or tools to me. It's not because I'm anti-client, it's because I'm pro-client. I want them to win, and I want them to win relatively quickly. Now, how do you teach out without a shock collar? You can do a prong, you can do a bonker, you can do claiming of space, you can do extremely hard leash pop. So a lot of ways you can do it. Next. Which are, by the way, FYI, are more invasive than a shock collar. The shock collar is the least invasive tool when it comes to these protocols. The least invasive tool. The most human neutral tool and the least invasive tool. Next.
Kelly, any tips on getting my dog used to clippers? He's okay with trimming his body area but growls when trying to trim his chest, legs, and paws.
I would talk to, I'm a dog trainer. I mean, we do counter condition dogs to different things like that, but I would actually jump onto some grooming podcasts. You find yourself a good groomer, they'll show you how to do some amazing things. Groomers are incredible dog handlers. Next.
JP. All right, we got some conflicting things here for the four corners. New Mexico, Arizona, Wyoming, Nevada. Ashley says Arizona, New Mexico, Utah, Colorado. Scandalisa says Nevada, Colorado, Utah, Arizona. And Teresa says, in all fairness, I'm from New Hampshire, but hope to see you in Texas soon. And then she says Arizona, New Mexico, Colorado, Utah. So we got two with those four. Cody says Arizona, Utah, Colorado, New Mexico. Are you Googling it?
Okay. Four corners.
Where are you going to put this?
So four corners.
Right there.
Yep, right there. I got Wyoming, Idaho.
Oh, Wyoming is part of it.
Utah and Colorado. Now.
No, we're here. You right there.
So I've got those four now.
New Mexico, Arizona, Utah. No Wyoming.
And Colorado.
Colorado.
Right. Okay. But there's also four states. Where are we talking about? Those are the four corners. They're literally corners.
Like right there. So you can be in all four states. There's like a little landmark there. See how right. They just match perfectly?
Yep, they do.
That's the four corners.
Right. That's right. Right by Route 160.
I want to go there. And,
by the San Juan River.
Take a picture there.
Well, if you drove out west with me, we would go there.
Who said I wouldn't drive out west?
Okay.
I'd have to take my dogs, though.
Oh, you can take your dogs.
Like five dogs in the RV. Cheyenne. My dog's e-collar came in today, and it's been working great. He was watching a cat today, and I pressed the button, and he turned around. I told him to double down, and he laid down and went to sleep.
Nice. Woo! Look at that.
Nice. Next. Goblin says, yeah, haha. Kara, if my dog breaks a known command, and I say no, and she goes back to the command, say she goes back into a down, do I still need to apply a punishment?
From a learning perspective, yes. Next.
Lisa, can a nickel allergy from e-collar make the dog itchy all over or just at the contact site? My girl has mystery itch, wears her e-collar all day until bedtime. Thanks.
That could be maybe a muscle stimulus or something else. That could be something totally not related. That's not my level of expertise. Next.
Mike, hi guys. Sorry I missed you the last few weeks. Maddie is doing great. Love you guys. So grateful for you.
Mike.
Hey, Mike. Where you been?
Super proud of you. You scared him away.
You scared him away. Remember you called him out that one show?
Are you going to be at the Providence Seminar, Mike? We'll take the restraining order off you.
Kara.
Sure, well, I'll just call the police tomorrow and take that back.
All right.
Next, go to the courthouse.
I'll allow it.
Next.
Kara, do most dogs usually push boundaries their whole lives? I have a GSD. I've been training with your videos for a year. I feel like she's constantly pushing boundaries. I feel I'm correcting often.
Okay. I don't know your skill set. I'm going to say that, like, this is a huge thing about skill set. Like, I don't know your skill set. So, with your skill set, they might. Mm-hmm. I don't know. Next.
Cassandra. When I was younger, I had two dogs. One was shorter than the other, and he would walk under the taller one anytime the taller one peed. We ended up letting them out separately because he always stank. Oh, my God.
That's so disgusting.
That's so gross.
Golden showers. I used to, when I was...
You have a name for it.
It's a golden shower.
Gross.
When I was in the adult business. So yeah. When I was in the adult business, we also threw fetish parties.
Mm-hmm.
And at these fetish parties, like...
No.
A lot went on.
No.
Do you know that I actually did a fetish cruise?
Yeah, the bus to Boston?
No.
A boat?
I rented a 140-foot long boat in Narragansett Bay.
Like a yacht?
140 foot. It wasn't a fucking rowboat. So, 140 foot. And it's designed for sightseeing. So, it's got lots of open space. We rented the whole boat to ourselves for the night. And we sold tickets.
Did you wear high boots?
I wore all fetish gear. And you had to be dressed up in fetish to get on there. And we had, we did S&M shows, and we did, there's a lot of stuff that went on that boat. We went on into international waters, so a real lot of stuff went on that boat. And then it came back at night. Yep.
Okay.
It was a long, that was at least 30 years ago. At least. Wow. A long time ago.
Feeling old?
There's some ammunition for all my haters. I did fetish cruises. Next.
Nancy, any suggestions on deterring fence climbing? I'm fostering a shepherd who can climb a 6-foot cyclone fence.
Yes. Keep a long line on that dog. Use a shock collar and make it suck beyond belief or you'll end up with a dead dog. Next.
Cassandra, we always bathe him, but it started to be more of a constant odor. Dorky dogs.
Yeah, of course.
Rescues and focus
those
dogs.
Would, sorry, those would be outside dogs, in my opinion.
Yeah, you can pee on each other out
yeah,
there.
Yeah, yeah.
Rescues and focus dog training. Take the blood pressure now. Hypertension is a silent killer. Love you both. I mean, I go for annuals, and I've always am pretty low. Like, what's the usual? 120 over 80?
I will take your...
I'm usually like 117 over like 70-something.
Okay. I will take your blood pressure tonight. We want to take it right now on the air?
I have a lot of caffeine in my system, but we'll see.
Does it matter?
Usually it elevates it a little.
You get your blood pressure and you get your pulse rate.
All right, we'll try it.
Next.
Kyle. Hi, Jeff. How can I get a 7-month-old German Shepherd and 11-month-old Doberman to coexist?
I don't know your skill set. I don't know the dogs. So that's what has a lot to do with it. So... You know, I don't know your training protocols. I don't know your routine. We got a thumbs down. Nice. It was right after the swingers party coming too. Next. It's not like I was send my. It's not like I like voiced my political party. It's like. Thanks for the thumbs down, whoever gave us that. Actually, appreciate that. Actually, thanks. I love the interaction. I have no idea what your skill set is. That's what's really important. So right now, get them to walk together, put up massive structure in your home, no free roaming, walk together, place together, get them to interact, hold them both accountable. Next.
66 El Camino. 9-month-old Doberman, excellent off-leash, hyper-reactive on-leash, doing well on prong, just me, and then sometimes all I have is one brain cell and two testy. I have one brain cell and two testy. I can bring us back, but some days, I don't know.
Your fucking writing skills suck, too! Jesus Christ! Can't you, without one brain cell, can't you fucking type out a sentence? What the hell? Obviously, you got... You got manual dexterity issues, too.
I think he's talking Shakespearean.
What?
Bring us back. Like Shakespeare.
Let's go to the next question until he answers it properly. Until he asks it properly.
Okay, I can't read. Kara. Oh, God. I've noticed my dog does better being calm in her kennel when other dogs are near her in their kennel sleeping. When she's crated in a room alone, she tries to break out, but only sometimes.
Yeah. That happens, too. The soothing feature of other dogs. When we have dogs that struggle with separation anxiety at home, they don't actually get kenneled up in our main kennel area. We actually put them in a room all by themselves because that's what it's going to look like when they're home. Next.
Mm-hmm. Rescues and focused dog training. Also, we have a dog who does great in our structured play group, but barks at other dogs, more so the little white ones, when she's on her leash. She's honestly the chillest dog I've ever met, just leash reactive, I guess.
Get yourself a proper shock collar, correct the dog. Next.
Julie, we just got a crate for our dog.
Nice. Congratulations.
Paper plane, Kathy. Considered the bandana already. No collars allowed at all, unfortunately. We're doing lots of crate training. Any advice on how to punish him in the crate without the e-collar on?
You can use the bonker. The thing is this. When after TSA puts it in cargo, there's nothing you can do. Next.
Scaredy floof. So nice to hear
someone. Hold on. Let me back up on that one. Okay. What I want you to do is this. I want you to pattern shutting up in the crate so well. Shutting up in the crate so well. I want that dog to be able to do downstays in that crate with a gate, with a door open and the door closed for hours. I want to make sure that dog can run into the crate and lie down. I want to make sure that dog, the rest of the day, is highly structured. Structure, 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 structure. How structured is the day out of the crates? What are the rules? You don't have to answer this now. What are the rules out of the crates? Everything right now needs to be choreographed. Everything needs to be predictable. And then also get your dog around loud noises. Remember, all the noises that we hear upstairs, up in the cabin, it's amplified down in cargo. So it's very loud down there. Next.
Scaredy floof. So nice to hear someone speak nicely of groomers, honestly. Thank you.
Yeah, why wouldn't I? Groomers are great.
Yeah.
Why would people not speak nicely of groomers?
I don't know. Anyone who can handle friggin' Wes and doing
his nails. Yeah, but not only that. It's like you're fucking unprofessional.
Yeah.
I mean, the ones I speak unhighly of, and I shouldn't even say unhighly, vets that give training advice. I'm just like, stay in your lane. Mm. That's it. Next.
St. Lee. What do I do when I pull in the driveway with my dog in the car and she sees the neighbor coming out of her apartment next to the driveway? She growls, I tell her no, she lowers head, but does it again.
Shock, cower, make it suck. See, this is the thing, it's like a lot of people are like, whoa, he just uses the shock collar for everything. It's like, no, but for a lot of the questions that people are asking me, it's the perfect tool. It's like the best tool for this. My dog's at the front window and it barks its head off, what do? Shock collar correction. My dog's at the back fence barking its head off, what do? Shock collar correction. My dog's chasing the cat, what do? Shock collar correction. My dog's in the car and it growls or barks at the neighbor, what do? Shock collar correction. It's the perfect tool. It's the perfect tool. How do I teach a good sit? Leash and food. A good down, leash and food. A good place, leash and food. Recall, leash and food. Roll over, food and a clicker. Paw, food and a clicker. Walk backwards, food and a clicker. Spin in circles, figure eights, food and a clicker. Like, there's great tools for so many applications, for so many applications. And on that note, I wanna talk about something. Somebody asked this question. I might have talked about this the other night. I might have talked about this Monday night, but somebody asked the question about, remember that video of you with that, I think it was with Chance, he was outside for the first time and you taught him to move away? Chance or Chase?
Who had the
Chase. Chase. Yeah. Chase. He's dog aggressive.
And social.
And social.
Yeah.
So you had him on the leash.
Yep.
And I think it was Thor or Kevin was out there. Mm-hmm. And the dog moved, and Chase moved away.
Mm-hmm.
And somebody asked, what tool did you use for that? And they listed bonker, shock collar, prong collar. And I said, not to be snarky, I said, what does it matter? And what I meant by what does it matter, it's if I told you the tool we used, how would that help you?
Right.
So let's say we use the shock collar. Now what are you going to do? You're still not going to know what to do.
Yeah, so many nuances.
There's so many nuances. Here's a great example. Mm-hmm. Here, let me make this even clearer for people and better to understand. How do I teach rollover? What tool do I use for rollover? Food and a clicker. Here's a bunch of food, here's a clicker. Go and come back in half an hour and show me a rollover. You most likely wouldn't know what to do. Have you seen my dog? You know what we'll do? Let's do a live tomorrow of Kira jumping off the wall.
Hit it, yeah.
Yeah, so I've got a dog and a lot of people have dogs. If I say hit it, she will run at a wall, leap up a couple of feet or 3 feet, hit the wall with all four paws and then bounce off the wall and come back out.
You have a picture of her doing it right there. Wait, on
oh,
a tree.
Yeah, right there. Do you see that on the tree right there? How did she learn how to do that? See that right there? She's hitting
it. That's a complicated trick.
Yeah.
It's like a ton of parts.
How did she learn how to do that? A ball and a clicker. So if I gave you a ball and a clicker, could you get your dog to do that? If you knew, no, you couldn't. But if you knew how to do it, you could. So what I mean by that is, guys, all training tools are neutral. Every collar, every leash, every harness, every training tool, they're neutral. So when someone says a shock collar is a shortcut, it's like, oh, so here's a shock collar, show me how to train my dog faster. And I probably would go like this, because you're an asshole for fucking saying that. You wouldn't know what to do. You would probably wouldn't know how to turn it on. And then you wouldn't know what buttons to push, then you wouldn't know when to push them, you wouldn't know what levels to use. Do you know that you have to actually have a leash there? Do you know that we actually use food? Do you know that we actually train the dog an obedience command and then layer the remote collar over it? Do you know that sometimes we use Nick, sometimes we use continuous? Do you know that we have to proof the dog, and then we have to go to punishment stage, then we have to do distant commands? And then we also have to do it for state of mind? Like, there's so many variables. But everybody's making it look like some of these tools, oh, you like to the shortcuts, you use a prong collar or a remote collar. Number one, it's not necessarily a shortcut at all. You can do more stuff with it, I'll tell you that much. So I think that's what it's important that people understand, this tool debate. It's like, One thing is they're just neutral. They just sit there. They have no meaning to them. Next.
Good point. Good rant. Jenny, how can I get my dog to gently take treats or toys out of my hands? She's rough. We'll try to snatch stuff out of my hands. This is something I should punish him for.
Yeah, I would use a bonker and bonk the dog on the head. Could also take the food, put it right there. And when you give it to the dog, nothing but a soft mouth will get it. Next.
JP, thanks. I've been working on Place and I've been following your video. If I say Place, he goes to Place, but I've been trying hard to get him to stay. He's not getting it yet. I use a prong collar.
Okay, good. So after you've done it 100 times, let's say.
One more part.
Oh, I'm sorry.
When I say no and take him back, he holds for barely a second and tries to come back to me.
Got it.
Tried for 20 minutes the past 5 days.
This is what I want you to do. It's time to apply a punisher. So prong collar and leash. No consequence. A quick pop. Not yank the dog off its feet. Okay? But no pop. Don't say pop. That's just the sound of the leash going. The dog goes, whoa, that sucked. I know. It did. Because we've trained you this before, and now you're not doing it. So, and then you say place again, the dog goes back. And then the dog goes, oh, so let me figure this out. If I leave it, I'm going to get a punisher. So I think I'll stay. Exactly. All these people out there that are repeating this story about, oh, the dog only holds command because it's afraid of getting punished. Yep. And you don't speed because you're afraid of getting a ticket. And you don't shoplift because you're afraid of going to jail. And you don't act like a jerk, hopefully in public, because you're afraid of getting the shit beaten out of you or thrown down a set of stairs or kicked out of an establishment. It's called rules. Or else we'd have anarchy. And there's rules. And us humans abide by them or should be abiding by them. And dogs also should be abide by them, or there should be a consequence. But you don't get any fucking eighth grade trophies. I can't tell you how many times this always sticks in my mind, and I always remember this, and I see this all the time. I was at a convention for working dogs, and they had some, it was like the Therapy Dog of the Year award, and it was this beautiful Newfie who went into hospitals. Beautiful dog, went into hospitals and dealt with elderly patients and sick patients and did a wonderful, wonderful job, I imagine. At least that's what the narrative was. It was sitting on stage with five other people and five other dogs. There was a police dog there, and there was a service dog there, and there was a search and rescue dog there. And this dog was standing there, and the owner had to continuously put treats in its mouth to get it to hold sit. And it kept breaking sits. This is a fully trained therapy dog that can't hold a fucking sit. I'm sorry, but you should be embarrassed. You should be embarrassed. Your dog can't hold a sit? We have dogs do, this is not like an ego statement, but we have dogs do sit stays in chairs on week two for 2 hours with lots of distractions. Angelo running by, me running by, dogs running by, and this dog is in a sit stay and doesn't move. And we have tons of videos of showing it. What I'm saying is, yeah, does he get any reward for staying in a sit stay? No, it does not. Why? We gave it rewards to train it how to do it. We are a reward-based company, meaning we use food to train what we want. But then once you know it, the rewards are gone. Well, how is that fun? Well, let me explain a little bit of rule of life to you. Getting corrected is not fun. So by doing the command, you don't get a correction. By showing up for work on time, you don't get fired. And you still get your paycheck. You're doing the minimum required. Showing for work on time gets you the minimum required to keep your job. It's because it's not your God-given right to get a paycheck. It's not your God-given right to keep your job. In the state of Rhode Island, everybody's an employee at will. You can be fired at any time for any reason. And I don't have a problem with that, and I'll tell you why. Because an employee can quit any time for any reason. So That's life. And it's important that our dogs, and especially our children, but also our snot-ass adults, and not these millennials, because I don't diss millennials at all. I'm not that guy. But it's more of an attitude. Next.
Julie, so Jeff and Joelle, you're coming back to California soon?
Yeah, we'll be in Petaluma. December, second weekend in December, we'll be there.
The 15th.
JeffGellmanSeminars.com. If you want a working spot, believe it or not, we announced this a week ago. They're almost sold out.
Again?
Yeah.
Wow.
Yeah, they're almost sold out. Yeah.
Monica, greetings. Regarding the nickel, I got a comfort pad for the mini educator. It works really well. No nickel.
Yeah, there's no nickel in the comfort pads.
My dog is all white and has very sensitive skin. It helped.
Ooh. Kudos to you. Next.
Pedro, Jeff, my GSD behaves at low-level e-collar, but when we're in public, other dogs, he doesn't behave at low-level stim, and I have to increase the stim. Why the difference?
Pedro, number one, I fucking voted for you, okay? Oh, number two. What?
Freaking, I can't believe you like that movie, of all movies.
I can't believe you like white chicks.
True.
Okay? Of all movies.
Napoleon,
yeah.
Anyway.
Terry Crews, topless, okay. I like that. I enjoyed that.
He's funny.
I love it.
Sorry.
No, I'm being serious. I enjoy that. Okay? But, and I like the opening scene.
Cool.
But that's it.
Got it.
Okay? So, I'm just joking. I'm busting your balls. All right? I hated every minute of it. Okay. So, this is it. You're in the library. You can have a conversation with him like this. You're outside. You're in a mosh pit. You need to talk louder. Talk louder. You gotta break through the nonsense. Next.
Ari, fuck, that boat sounds amazing. Fetish world is always the most fun.
It is. Yep, Ari. Ari looks like a player.
Maybe.
Ari's the one with the shaved head, right?
Mm-hmm.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Yep. I'll give you a whole thing about my shaved head female experiences. Linda had a shaved head. A lot of shaved head girls. Nothing sexier than a woman with a shaved head. Next.
Teresa, that's normal. Joel, 100 to 120 over 60 over to 80 is considered normal range.
I know. When I was hospitalized, rushed to the hospital, it was 225 over 140, I think.
Oh, my God.
Yeah. Yeah, they rushed me in the hospital. Yeah, I just went in there. I was like, I don't feel very well. I just walked up. Next thing I know, I'm like on a gurney, like up to machines, getting pumped in with shit. And I go right up to a fucking...
Your heart was probably not even like...
And I go right up to a suite, and I'm like, geez, they got good service here.
I know. I remember you were like Instagram storying
yes.
it.
And then the next... And then
you're like, I get to take a break in the hospital.
And then when I finally got released... All of a sudden, I felt really ill again, and I checked my blood pressure, and it was high again. It was like 165, and I'm like, shit, I better get back in there, because they told me to come back in. I got back in, they took my blood pressure, and they're like, oh, you can wait in the waiting room. And I'm like, wait in the waiting room, and I'm like...
You're unhealthy, but you're not that unhealthy.
I'm like, I don't remember it being like this. Yeah. Next.
Teresa, no food or drink 20 to 30 minutes before taking blood pressure for more accurate results.
I know.
Well, we're just going to wing it anyway, because yeah. I want to know.
Yes, but she hasn't. She's had just water.
Cassandra, well, a super fluffy Pomeranian Chihuahua probably couldn't be an outdoor dog. He was so dumb, he probably wouldn't be able to find his own food bowl if it wasn't
it
always was.
Oh, the Pomeranian was getting pissed on.
Yes. Yeah. Julie, we have introduced our crate to our dog. She is 4 years old but was never socialized as a puppy, so she had the mindset of an energized puppy, but the full-grown body of an adult dog. That's all. Oh,
cool.
Wait, so we are making her crate the new place. Any advice?
Yeah, crate your dog and tell your dog to shut up if it makes noise. Guys, crate protocols are this. Go in the crate and shut up. It's as simple as that. It's as simple as that. Next.
66 El Camino says, sorry, I got lost in translation. I am German. Just as mean. I'm just kidding.
But you could ask the question in German. Sprechen Sie Deutsch? I mean, you could ask the question in German. Probably would have come across well better than that.
Cassandra said, bring it. Sounds like a German keyboard. Autocorrect. I think it sounds like Shakespeare. Bringest me my coffee.
Right.
I'll start saying that. Steve, first board and train. It's been 2 days. Dog won't take food. It's not toy motivated. Not human or dog aggressive. How do I begin training?
You can use high profile treats or just wait it out next. How do you begin training? Leash training. Just start working the dog next.
66 El Camino. I sometimes can't bring my pup back after overstimulation.
Bonk the dog next.
Chandler, I work at a boarding daycare facility. We house Humane Society dogs and are allowed to do e-collar training, but vibrate is our preferred mode. Still new, but I see that they're being underwhelmed. I want to try out some of the skills I've learned from you, tried out, and found success on my own dogs, but I'm uneasy on how to bring it up to my new employer.
Well, you can ask them, why do we use vibrate? And their answer is, because it's more humane. And I'm going to be like, really? Says who? Says your human mind? Why is it when I use vibrate on dogs, they shit and they piss and they shake? Why is that? Right? So, because vibrate sounds better than shock. It also, it makes a good sound bite, and it also doesn't take away from donations. No, we're not using shock collars. We use vibration collars. It just vibrates the dog. It doesn't hurt the dog. It just vibrates the dog. Really? That's why you just fucking lost your fucking bowels on the floor, dog? That's why you just pissed all over the place? That's why you're shaking? Next.
Rachel, 9-month Staffy has purposely bitten husband and I, breaking skin during play, such as chase, tug, or when viewing as running. Do you think it's aggression, and how do you recommend fixing this?
It's probably not aggression, but if you're going to get your dog jacked up, you better be able to get your dog to stop immediately. I would probably say this might be an owner issue here, an owner-handler issue. So what you're going to do is, number one is, you have to tell that dog it's not allowed to put its mouth on you ever. So you have to come up with a punisher that you can't put your mouth on you ever. Next.
Kara, I don't consider myself a professional. I enjoy working with dogs and helping people handle them, as I have with many people. I dog sit, walk for. I'd like to start a business. Not sure if I'm good enough.
Who's that, Kara?
Kara,
I bet you're kick ass. Do you know more than your next door neighbor? Do you know more than the people on your block? Can you add value to the community? Can you walk into somebody's home that has a pulling, lunging dog, non-aggressive, a dog that won't go in a crate, a dog that doesn't know sit, down, place, that can't walk on a leash, a dog that barks too much? Do you know how to solve those people's problems? Are you a very good people person? Do you love people more than dogs? You should, by the way. FYI, a good dog trainer loves people more than dogs. If you answered yes to all of those things, that is a $100,000 a year business. If you want to know how, all the breadcrumbs have been laid by me on all my social media platforms. You're welcome to do a Skype. That's actually how I make a living. Next.
Rescues and focused dog training. Corrected the crap out of it with a mini educator. Also, I love groomers. I could train basic dog commands, but I can my dog to smell as clean like when my local groomer does it. Bless their skills.
Yep, exactly. Next.
Paper plane. Thank you so much, Jeff. Our day is really structured due to anxiety, which is not really improving though. 90% in place or crate when inside. No roaming. Crated overnight. Heel morning and evening.
Nice.
Walk. Then some search work midday.
Ryan Gill got a $1.99 from Ryan Gill. I guess YouTube gave him a free super chat.
Nice.
He threw it our way. Look at you, Ryan.
So nice.
Look at you. Next.
JP, also want to say thanks for these broadcasts, guys. I've been working out to your streams, and I'm down 30 pounds. I'm 40 pounds away from my goal.
Get the fuck out.
That's awesome.
Bam.
Boom.
Look at you.
Nice.
Wow. Holy shit. Damn. You should have Joelle write you a workout plan. You'll get that 40 pounds off. Meal plan and workout plan. What's that bar that you use?
Redcon 1.
Mm-hmm. How can people get a hold of that?
They can go to the website, but if you go to my Instagram page, I have a link right there.
Okay, next.
Paper plane, I already read that. Rachel B, we want to be able to play with her, but we cannot find any way to play without her getting aggressive and turning that aggression on my husband and I by biting us.
Okay, you need to learn how to properly play with your dog. This is going to be hard on a Skype, I mean on a free show, okay? First of all, stop playing right now. Just stop. Go to zero right now. Just go to zero. It's not working. Okay? I can see the two grown-ass adults out in the backyard playing with this dog, getting bit, yelling at their dog. That's not fun for anybody. Like, are you envisioning that right now? I'm envisioning that right now, mm-hmm, right? Mm-hmm. So, stop. Stop doing it until you learn how to do it right. Next.
Scott, hi Jeff. My 10-month-old Doberman was attacked on leash by a staff bull terrier who was off leash. I corrected my dog for reacting wrong. What is the best way to handle the situation?
No, don't do that anymore. Kick the shit out of the other dog. Next.
Jacqueline, we need a What Would Jeff Do merchandise that says, stay in your lane.
Okay.
Kaylee J, almost corrected my cat for walking off her cat bed because I thought it was the dog getting up off place.
Because your cat and dog look familiar. Next.
Ashley, I'm okay to hold a bonker while using it, or is it preferable to throw? I have horrid aim at the moment.
Okay, you have horrid aim. Okay, that's your story today. Get a milk jug, okay? Water or milk. Empty. Put it on the ground by the front door. Stand 12 feet away. Make 3 bonkers. Deploy each one 12 times. That's 36 reps. Move around like you're shooting baskets. Do that every night for a week. Next week, tell me, are you or are you not someone with good aim? Next.
Seaton, Jeff, don't just love your training, but also the fact that you're not afraid to be politically correct. Rare to find someone who's not afraid to speak their mind. Ever in London, England, drinks are on me.
Politically correct or incorrect?
Probably, they put correct, but they probably mean incorrect.
Yeah, I'm very politically incorrect. I'm respectful. I think I'm respectful.
Yeah, you're just like blunt, though.
I'm blunt. Blunt as fuck. So I'll be in the UK. I don't drink. I'll take some tea. You know, Joelle doesn't drink. She doesn't drink either. But let me tell you the time I stayed in a bed and breakfast. Right by the zoo station and the main station there. The rooms are so fucking small. For all my UK people, you'll do this. The rooms are so small. When you open the door, it slams into the bed.
Wow. You're making me yawn.
Like, if you weigh more than 200 pounds, you're not getting through that fucking door.
So is it just like a bed in a room?
Pretty much a bed in a room. And it had a sink in it, and there's a toilet in the hall.
It's like a hostel?
No. It was an Airbnb. It was a bed and breakfast. Mm. You just don't have your own bed. You don't have your own bathroom.
I couldn't stay there.
But I've stayed in hostels too.
I could not stay where I don't have my own bathroom.
Yep. Next.
Britain, my dog is doing awesome. All your videos. She is very nice, not aggressive to our old and mean cat.
Awesome.
But she is annoying it and us. She is 1 year old, and I think she wants to play. But still, thinking of crafting with e-collar.
I would use the e-collar or the bonker. Next.
Derek, thanks for all your content. Massive improvement in our dog's behavior the last couple of weeks with the e-collar.
Nice.
Can groom him finally. Tonight's show is helping me through this night shift.
Awesome. I'm really happy. Guys, I'm so happy for all of you. Do you know that it's incredible? I find it so funny. This week, now that our comments are open up on our YouTube, I'm getting all these comments that say, geez, Jeff, you seem really angry. It seems like you don't like people. Like, literally, people are commenting that to me.
What goggles are they wearing?
It's like, what?
Yeah, they just see the 1 minute clip of you like, going on a rant.
But even that, like, I don't like people? I'm like, wow. I'm blown away.
I saw that your colonoscopy video went up today.
Yeah, it did. You see that one little warning there? I gotta ask for a whole... Have them build a holy hospital for you. whispering somebody. Whispering who?
The fact that you even said, though, like, I've, like, watched a little bit of it, and I'm like, what would possess you? You're like, I told him not to use the lube, because I kind of like that. I kind of like the sensation.
Well, I do. I usually bring a stack of 20s, and I got to tip everybody, too.
Yeah, and you're going to freaking live
stream. Were you in my room? There's a 20. Were you in my room? There's a 20.
You have the nurse film?
Everybody with rubber gloves, 20s all around. Next.
Kendra, Jeff, you have done so much to help me understand the tools I at one time was so against.
Yeah, I know.
You have given my husband, who has never owned a dog, so much insight. Thank you so much.
My pleasure, man. Thanks for all of you for being great educators, too. Next.
Seton, based on their look, I was scared of using a prong collar. Your video explaining changed my mind.
I know.
One day, and the improvement has blown my mind.
I know.
Had two trainers before, fail to improve her. Thanks.
See, this is the thing. It's like, everybody, guys, first of all, I don't mind being given a hard time. I don't mind getting all the hate that I get. I get so much hate online, it's incredible. I don't mind people make videos on me. I'm on the forums, people bashing me. I'm so aware of what gets said around me because I get screenshots. And by the way, guys, if you're on a private forum, a private group, and you're saying shit, not just about me, but any dog trainer, just a little FYI, I get the screenshots. I don't ask for them, but people send them to me because a large majority of your group, they're actually fans of mine. And they're like, look what people are saying about you. And I'm like, I know. So just to let you know, I just did a thing on Instagram stories about this. It's like, when you go on as a professional dog trainer, if you go on even a private forum, your private forum, and you bash another trainer, I'm just letting you know that the universe has seen that, and the universe goes, wow, that's not a very nice person. I'm going to check them off the list of people I'm going to recommend. It hurts your business. It doesn't hurt me. And some really nasty stuff is being said about me right now. It's not hurting my business. My phone keeps ringing. My seminars keep doing well. This show keeps growing. My employees are kicking ass. We're looking for new people to hire, actually. And it's more of an indication of the person saying the message than what the message is about. But I'm amazed, though, at the narrative that's set out there because my reality is much different.
Mm-hmm.
Like, totally. My reality is like, we're helping lots and lots of people.
Yeah.
Like, a lot of people. I'm really shocked by people. Like, are you that naive? Like, you're that ignorant. So instead of bashing, what you should do is do what I do. Observe.
Yeah.
Sit back, bust your ass working, put out massive amounts of free content, help people with no obligation with anything in return, and watch human behavior. And you always know, it's like, interesting.
Mm-hmm.
Interesting. You want to make fun of my sex industry? I'll tell you about the swingers parties, and I'll tell you about the fetish shows, and I'll tell you about the anal sex 101 class that I taught, in the female ejaculation class that I've taught at Brown University, guys. It's an Ivy League school. Okay? I'll tell you about all this stuff. Like, this is not the 40s or 50s.
Yeah.
Women have sex. Women masturbate. Couples are intimate. Couples are struggling. You know?
Mm-hmm.
Divorces happen because of problems in the bedroom.
Yeah.
So, like, this is some big secret. Like, everything you read about me online, I put it there.
You published it.
I published it.
Yeah.
It's called press releases. Next.
Seton, I already read that. Julie, I also got Lily, our dog, to hold place for a good 20 minutes today. That was huge for us. Thank you.
Awesome.
Next. Oh, God, these people are killing it. Seton, we'll make a donation end of the month when I get paid. I know the dog is fixed and can away without paying. Honestly, though, I owe you and you be improved both my life and my dog's.
Yep.
Steve, Jeff, the tone out of crate bonk for separation anxiety is working great on Vader. Left him for 2 hours today, no issues. I actually got out of the house. Thanks.
Nice. Wow. Now that's a game changer for you. Next.
Cody says, White Chicks is awesome. Thanks, Cody.
Okay. I laughed. I had a nice time.
It's a funny ass movie.
Next. It's one of your top favorites,
it's
though.
It's number one, probably, besides National Lampoon's Christmas Vacation.
Next.
Have you seen that? That's a funny ass
I've seen
movie,
it,
too.
I've seen it 10 times.
Seton, LOL, vote Pedro, Jeff. You seem like a guy who'd be cool to hang out with, man.
Thanks.
He puts tater tots in his pocket.
I always got tater tots in my pockets.
Always. On Annie, used e-collar on 8-month-old lab for recall, and no, she didn't get hurt, but actually learned to come when called in only one session. Yay.
Nice. Congratulations.
I want another dog and have a 17-month-old staff. How do I bring the dog one along, please?
How is your 17-month-old doing with other dogs? Is it well socialized? Is it well behaved? Can you control its arousal? Get a dog, probably not a puppy, maybe something, you know, around 6 months, maybe under, maybe a year old, if you want, and just see, and make sure that dog is also social. Make sure they've got compatible play styles. Next.
Ari says, please, no, I'm at work.
What's that about?
With her shaved head.
Oh, Ari.
Fetish club.
Ari, are you getting excited, honey? Next.
Stop! The lady's at work! Okay.
Sit down at your desk.
Next. Julie, awesome that you'll be back in California.
Yes, I will.
I'm Thanks. So uncomfortable just sitting here. Shayna, I live in building.
This is the last show Joelle is ever
Never
going to
again.
Never gonna do.
I know my neighbor directly across from me for over 40 years. We both had several dogs over the years. She recently got a schnoodle, and puppy always jumps on me when I try to correct. Neighbor gets really pissed off at me and says she doesn't care if I'm a trainer, doesn't want me to correct her dog.
Okay, it's got nothing to do with being
dog
a trainer.
Dog is sweet enough with the jumping already. Neighbor is very high strung.
Okay, so guess what? You unfortunately... Okay, it's got nothing to do with you being a trainer. Nobody wants their dog jumping on them. Nobody. So your owner's... That owner's being selfish. So unfortunately... Hey neighbor... I'd like to come over, but you got to put your dog away. Oh, you're not dogs away? Sorry, I can't come over. Next.
Julie, awesome that you'll be back in California.
Yes.
Shayna, I live in building. I know my neighbor directly across. I already read that.
Yep.
Seton, I know nothing can beat hands-on experience. Could you recommend any books for someone interested in a career as a dog trainer, animal lover, and you've motivated me big time. Like to learn more.
Closing the Gap by my buddy Sean O'Shea. Go to thegooddogway.com. Next.
Karen, GSD lover. Good evening, Jeff and Joelle. Hi, Karen.
Hey, Karen.
Elizabeth, what can I do about my dog? We use the prong collar on him, and he's fine on the walk, but as soon as he sees another dog, biker, or skater,
yep.
He lunges and barks and almost bites me and my husband for correcting.
Yep, so it's a timing issue. I'd muzzle the dog up. I'd work him through. That, there's a lot of nuances on. I don't want you just cranking on the dog. So that's usually worthy of a Skype session. What I would start doing, though, is muzzle up the dog, apply your punisher prior to the escalation. Next.
Marina, our 7-week-old mini golden doodle has trained with a prong, and he has responded very well to it. I want to take his training to the next level. Should I progress to an e-collar now?
Yep. Yep. Sounds good. Next.
Shayna, correct dog. Oh, I read that already. Do-do-do. Shayna says, what should I do about the situation?
If I went to someone's house and their dog jumped on me all the time, I would not go to their house. Guys, let's think rationally. Stop going to their house or tell them to put the dog away or you won't come in. End of story. If they want to lose friendship over their asshole dog, that's on them. Next.
JP, wait, does Joelle write workout plans? I'm interested.
Yes, she does. Joelle is a fitness trainer. She does workout plans. Are you still doing those?
I'm only taking on like one or two clients a month right now.
Yeah, so very limited. Yeah. Very limited. Next.
Mike, have you ever tried to train wolves?
No, I have not. I've worked with packs of feral dogs, though. Next.
Seton, fuck what they say in private. Your results speak volumes.
Oh, I don't give a shit.
They're keyboard warriors who would have better behaved dogs if they spent more time training and less time talking shit. Huge fan here.
Seton, just to let you know, it doesn't bother. I've done so many rants on this. It doesn't bother me. I love it. It makes me so much money. Next.
Kendra, I looked up some of the videos on you and they bring up sex seminars as if that's an issue.
Yeah, yeah. It's so funny. I know which ones you're talking about as well. Notice how you'll never see me commenting on them, ever. You'll never see me, ever.
It's probably why you have such good human skills.
Yeah, it's like, how could, and that's another thing. If people are writing shit about you, guys, stop responding. Leave it alone. Like, I'm responding sort of now in a general term, but I would never, ever, ever respond on someone else's page. It's their page. Never respond on their page. I stay in my lane. I do my own thing. Plus, I don't give a shit if people like me or not. Like, I wish people really could understand that. I actually don't care. Talk crap about me. I don't care. You think you're hurting my feelings? Pshaw. Next.
I have no idea what you're saying right now. Scott, thanks, Jeff. I did kick the staff that was attacking my Doberman.
Good.
If this happens in the future with my dog on leash, what's the best
bear
thing to do?
Bear spray. Spray the dog right in the face. Next.
Sebastian, for my dog's marking issue, I think I'll correct in the house if he ever tries it, or if he brushes other dogs' marks on fresh spots. I'll keep you updated.
Yeah, let me know how that goes. Next.
Thiago, hey, Jeff. Thanks for all the wisdom you share with us. And how do I get you to come to Brazil? Florianopolis. You'll love it, and I'll love it, and you'll love it too.
Yeah.
Where do I go to exchange information?
So, we got to get Raquel in on this. So
Raquel from Brazil.
We got to get Raquel on this. So this is the thing. I'm hired help. I'm willing to go to a seminar anywhere. In order for me to do a seminar, I need to generate a certain amount of revenue. Okay? I mean, this is what I do for a living. And I'm in no position to take a lost leader. So, international seminars, I don't do as well financially as I do my domestic ones because my travel expenses are so astronomical. I have to fly two of us there. We need either two separate rooms or we need an Airbnb that has got two separate sleeping areas, number one. And then there's food
preferably
for two. Preferably two bathrooms, but that hasn't happened in a long time.
I know.
Florida.
Yeah.
Florida.
Great.
Too bad we had two separate wings.
I know.
My God.
That's great.
Yeah.
I had that long hallway.
Yeah. But the bathroom thing works out pretty well.
Yeah.
It works out well. We've got different weirds. You shower constantly and I barely do. Yeah. So it works out. It works
shower
out fine.
A lot.
And a lot of times some of the bathrooms have got sinks on the outside. On the outside, yeah. So, but two rooms works out. Hotels that are inexpensive, two rooms works out great because then we have our own privacy. But anyway, so it's getting back to like why. So it's expensive. It's very expensive to do. So I need to generate enough revenue, and that's usually through anywhere from 15, about at least 15 working spots, 15 audit spots, and that's usually my break even for international stuff. So Jeff@solidcaninetraining.com. That would be ideal. If you're already a trainer and you already have a built-in audience, that's also helpful. Next.
Julie, White Chicks is awesome funny. Thanks, Julie. Yeah. I think it's pretty freaking hilarious myself. I quote it every day.
Next.
Thiago says, Google Florianopolis. You'll really love it. Bring all the family. Sounds like a cartoon.
So all the family won't go because it's to coordinate that, plus with ballet right now with Romy. Romy right now is in a 5 week, 6 day a week, 9 hour a day, ballet intensive. Hardcore. Next.
She's such a dancer.
Yeah.
Elier, hi Jeff and Joelle. Thanks a bunch for all the great content. Keep it coming.
You're welcome. It ain't going anywhere. We're gonna keep it coming. Next.
JP, quick, last question. I have an English bulldog. I'm trying to figure out what's best for fitting the prong collar. If I add a link, it's a bit loose. If I take it off, it looks like it's right in his neck rolls.
Up high and snug. If it's a little bit loose but it doesn't fall down, no big deal. Next.
Adriana, Jeff, is it true that if a puppy, a 4 month old, gets shipped by plane, it can mess the puppy's confidence, or can a puppy be prepared for a trip?
The breeder can prepare the dog for the trip, no problem at all. And Adriana, my invitation for you to talk to me if you're struggling, it is open. Do you got it? You know how to get a hold of me. We've Skyped before. All right? Life is short. All right, hon? I'm right there with you. Next.
Shayna, sometimes we just open our doors at the same time. We don't go into each other's apartment.
Oh!
But we're in such close proximity, sometimes it just happens.
Fucking just kick the dog. It's like, complain to the landlord. Complain to the landlord. Complain to the building manager. Do an anonymous complaint to the building manager. Next.
Thiago says, I understand the financial stuff. That's exactly what I need to know. Thanks again.
Yep. So if you're a trainer and you've got a facility, we can probably make it work. And I'm willing to do almost break even to go into a new country. Singapore, I'm willing to almost break even. If I went down to Brazil, I'm almost willing to break even. I have no problem with that at all. None at all. If I can help a lot of people, I'm just not in a position to do a lost leader in a foreign country right now. Next.
Ari says, also, happy you got a Brisbane location. I'm sure I'll be there.
Ari, yes, you will. And you won't be at work, so be careful. Next.
Cassandra, how's Clover liking helping for the summer so far? You think any of your kids will follow in your footsteps?
Probably not, because I'm probably not going to have this business. You know what I mean? I mean, I'm a businessman, which, oh my God, that's terrible. That's another thing that people give me a hard time about. He only cares about money. Mm-hmm. It's like, if you want to pay my $40,000 a month break-even point to run my company, you go right ahead. I don't care about money anymore. But until I hit that break-even point, I care about money. And then until I make X amount of dollars to support my huge family, I don't care about money. But sorry, I don't want to be living in my car. Nothing is living in my car. You know, I live in my RV, frankly. But it's like, I got no prosperity issues. And being in the voluntary transaction business, which a dog trainer is, it's like, all that means is that I'm helping tons of people. That's all it means. This is what dog trainers need to freaking smarten up.
Yeah, you're just bringing value.
You're just bringing value to the marketplace. Yeah. That's it, man. Dog trainers need to really understand basic economics. Yeah. So, next.
Julie, I started following your friend Sean O'Shea too.
Oh, Sean's good. He's going to be flying out here on Sunday with a mystery woman whose name is Marta.
She's not a mystery anymore.
I know. Yep.
Kendra, oh, I forgot. I had a question I've been saving for you. If you have clients that are not cool with training tools, do you take them on or try to work around it? They seem to want immediate results with no real work on their part.
Right.
I'm a new trainer, so I don't know if I can deliver results in the same time they need or if I'm unable to use tools.
No. You don't take them on as clients. You don't take them on as clients. Next. I'd rather have you work with somebody for free that's on board. Next. Why are you laughing?
Because you said next in the middle of your sentence. Like, I knew you weren't done yet. And you literally said next. Next. Teresa, my boyfriend said for me to ask you if you would hire me out here in no man's land, Oklahoma, LOL.
I'm not. Wait, am I hiring?
Would you hire her?
Yeah, if you moved to Rhode Island, I would. And if you're good. But what am I going to have you do out there? If you've got video skills, I can have you do video editing. Next.
Thiago says, thanks, amazing person.
Oh, thanks, Thiago.
Britain, thank you so much, and great show tonight. I will bonk my dog with the mean cat. Thank you again.
Britain, you're welcome.
Next. Mada, I think we should close it with this anyway. Okay. It's the last one. So much questions, only 36 thumbs up. Come on, people. J&J are awesome, and for free, try it. It doesn't hurt. Thumbs up.
So, Mada, this is the thing. Mada, I just want everybody to know, I don't do this for thumbs ups. I don't do this for thumbs downs. I don't do this for ratings. I don't do it for views. I don't do it for top chats. I don't do it for any of that whatsoever. All I do is this. 3 days a week at 8 p.m., I sit in front of my desk. It starts before that, actually, way before that. And I say, mentally. And all I care about is this. How can I give the most value to the marketplace by asking for nothing in return? That's all I care about. And you guys delivered. And what I mean by that is, you're doing the work, you're kicking ass, you're interacting, you're showing up every single freaking week. You're jumping into our Instagram and participating. You're jumping into our Facebook and you're participating. You're looking, watching all of our other YouTube videos. Michelle, where are you?
Michelle Anderson.
You're showing up at our seminars. We have so many super fans that are at our seminars. You're hiring us to come into our board and train. I'm always surprised. Someone's going to hear the rant about swingers club and fetish parties, and they'll be like, I think I want to send my dog there.
I'm going to send my dog
It's so funny because I think that blows people away.
Yeah.
It blows people away. I can't tell you how many people will like come. They literally, I mean, it's one thing to go to a seminar. It's like, you know, but But they'll actually spend $4,000 on a boarding train, and they'll be like, oh yeah, the thing that thing that struck me was that podcast. Remember when you talked about like the swingers parties? Like, I'm like, okay, and that got you in the door.
Yeah.
You know?
Oh yeah.
Ari's probably going, man, if I was in Brisbane, Jeff, I'd be in the door. I'd camp out in the door.
Oh boy.
So, but this is the thing, it's like, people don't get it. Mm-mm. They just, they're not aware. They're not on the pulse of the marketplace. They're not on the pulse of the marketplace. Mm-hmm. And they're also struggling with their own insecurities.
Exactly.
That's what the big thing is. They're struggling with their issues.
Yep.
The issues that they've been... They're programming from a young age, their issues from a young age.
Yeah.
And they have not been able to work through those issues yet.
Mm-hmm.
That's what the big thing is.
Yeah.
That's what a lot of it is. So I find it very, very... Man, I love people so much.
Me too.
I just love to observe. I love to interact.
Mm-hmm.
I love to listen.
And whenever people, like, we have a lot of clients who come in, like, oh, yeah, I see you on the podcast. They're never quoting, like, Jeff told me to do X, Y, and Z. They're quoting, like, the funny shit.
Yeah.
The dumb shit that we do on it. They're like... I didn't expect you to be like this in person, like
calm and quiet
at work. Yeah.
When you actually see me at work, they're like, geez, you're really quiet, Jeff. And I'm like, I'm in a professional environment, number one.
Like, they
I know, though. Like, yeah, I mean, I can't act like this in at work.
No.
Like, we can't act like this at work. We can't talk like this.
We hardly interact at
work. Yeah, we're colleagues. We can't be doing this. So, all right, everybody. Thank you.
Bye.
Take care. Love you all. Bye-bye.